All right. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our Application Thursdays. My name is Tanner Gillette. I am the Assistant Director of Graduate Recruitment here at the UB School of Nursing. These Application Thursdays events, we are doing the third Thursday of every month now through March. Last month's Application Thursday was in regards to letters of recommendation, which can now be found on our website if you'd like to go back and watch the recording. These are short presentations that go over one specific component of the application for the Graduate School of Nursing. This is being recorded so that we can use it for future publication on our website, on our social channels, and sent out to students so you can refer back to this. So please keep yourself on mute during the entirety of the presentation. At the end of the presentation, I will stop the recording. So for those of you that are on the call, you can either use the chat or unmute yourself once the presentation has been done recording. So with that, let's get to it. So before I go over the actual application, because that's really what we're doing today, I took some screenshots and we're just going to be going point by point on how to fill out the UB application to the Graduate School of Nursing. Just two things to note, all programs at UB, so not just the School of Nursing, use this application. So when you're filling it out, it's important to make sure that you're selecting the correct program and the correct school. I often have students that will message me and say, well, I can't find my program. And it's either because they started an application to a different school that wouldn't have our program linked to it. And you will only be able to apply to the program of your choice during the application period for that program. So if you fill out an application prior to or after the application period, you won't be able to select the program of choice. So your application will basically be null and void. So starting off, all applications for the School of Nursing will start off on this webpage. This is how you get to the UB application through the School of Nursing webpage. I put the link down here at the bottom, but it's pretty all over our webpage, should be easy to find. This is the application instructions on how to fill out the application. So basically this presentation is this webpage. So at the top, you see the chart for the applications that we are currently accepting for. So that's the first thing that you should be doing. You should be making sure that the program that you're looking to apply for is listed there. If it's not, that means that the application isn't open and you should not start an application. Or if you think it should be open, please feel free to email me. And sometimes, you know, there's some technical stuff, but it's always good to check and make sure before you do that. So basically, first thing you need to do is you need to read through all of these instructions. This will be pretty clear on exactly what you need to do for the entirety of the process. We've streamlined it pretty closely. And then when you have read through all of these, you're going to click this button down here that I've highlighted with an arrow, the Apply to the Graduate Programs. So when you click that button, this is the page that it's going to take you to. So you have two options here. You can either log in to continue your application that you may have already started, you just didn't finish, or you can create a new account to start your application. If you create a new account, there's just a few things that you have to input, pretty self-explanatory, it pops right up. So when you've selected those, and if you're creating a new account, filled in your information, it takes you to this page. This is the application manager. So as you can see, because I do this and I test out applications all of the time, I have quite a lot of applications that are open. So if you have applications that are open, they're going to be listed here. They're going to be listed. The progress is going to be there. The status rather, when you started the application and if you submitted the application. So as you can see, I've got quite a few for like older programs. It's just because I do this for a living and I have to test out lots of applications. So that's why those are all open for me. Or if you're ready to start a new application, I've circled the button down, the link rather at the bottom, you would start a new application. So if you click this, it'll bring you to this page. So this is the first page that comes up. You're gonna wanna make sure that an application is selected from the first drop-down menu. And then you're going to want to make sure that the School of Nursing is selected. Like I said before, it's important to make sure that you're selecting the correct school that you want to apply to. Once you've selected the School of Nursing, you're going to want to create an application. Once you create the application, this is the first page that comes up. It's not one long application. There are several individual pages that you will kind of fill in. First, the first thing that you're going to want to do is select the term, because each program is related to a specific term. We don't accept every program for every term. So you first select the term, and then you select the degree program. Most common reason that students can't find their program that they want to apply to is that they are selecting the wrong term. So step one, select the term that you want to apply to. Step two, select the program that you want to apply to. Excuse me. And then step three, for some of our programs, there is a post-bachelor track and a post-master's track. Select the one that seems most comfortable for you. If you're unsure, just send me a quick email and I'll be able to let you know which one you should apply to. And this does not apply to all programs. Some programs will not give you the option. I specifically chose PhD because it does give you that option so that people on here can see the information. So then you'll hit the continue button, and basically you will just go through step by step, personal information, additional background questions, academic backgrounds, school of nursing questionnaires, activities, distinctions, recommendation, sign it, and then you review it. There's no point in going slide by slide because it's pretty self-explanatory. You don't need to see me type in my name and address a few times and answer and check some boxes, but it's all very self-explanatory. So you will fill this out in its entirety. When you're ready to submit it, this is the last page. So we've gone through, we've selected our program, we filled in our personal information, filled out all the additional background stuff, school nursing questions, recommendations, all that type of stuff. And this is the final page. So as you see, we have a problem because I did not put in any recommenders for my recommendations. So this stopped me to make sure that I did this correctly. So this is going to be the final page. When you get to this page, if you have any of these things wrong, you will not be able to submit your answers. Obviously, because I'm an administrator, I have this little thing that pops up. You won't have that, but this will be any issues. So if you do have any issues, hit the red link that's right there, and it'll bring you back to whatever tab there is an issue and highlight what you need to complete in order to get this through. So let's assume that we've corrected everything. Everything is good to go. We are ready to submit our application. Or you may have some issues, but you don't have time to fix them right now. That's all right. Save it for later. And if that's the case, it'll bring you back to this page when you log back in, and you'll find the application that you started, Nursing Fall 2023. You'll click it, and it'll bring you right back to your application, and you'll just go through whatever you didn't fill in before. All right. But let's assume we have submitted the application and we are ready for review. So we've submitted it. Two things are going to happen pretty instantaneously, maybe not within 30 seconds, but I would say within 10 minutes or so. You will get this email sent to you, whatever email you used. In this email, it will give you access to two things. One, it will give you access to the status portal. And two, it will give you access to pay your application fee. On the status portal is where you're going to upload what we call supplemental documents. Often I get students asking, well, I filled out the application, but there wasn't anywhere for me to upload your resume or your personal statement. That's all right. You don't do that on the actual application. You do that on the status portal. Again, outlined on that web page, the application instructions. So you'll log into there and you will upload your documents. It's very important that you save this email. Do not delete this email because this link is special to you. Now, things happen. If you accidentally do delete this email, that's all right. Just let me know and I can resend this to you. But this is going to be important for you to save. All right, so now you're ready to log on to your portal. On your portal, this is what it's going to look like. Obviously, it's small because I tried to get as much of it in the screen as possible, but this will kind of give you a good idea. So this is going to be your application status portal. This is where you're going to complete all of your application, and this is also where your admission decision will be released. So the first link I want to bring your attention to is you're going to this link here to pay your application fee. There's very few fee waivers, application waivers that SUNY allows. That is a SUNY controlled thing. So most students will need to click here and pay their application fee. The application fee for all of our programs is $75. You're going to want to verify your address. I did black out my address for obvious reasons. Then your personal statement. We don't ask for like a blanket personal statement like some schools. It is a personal statement, but we are asking students to answer 4 specific questions. So before you upload your personal statement, before you write your personal statement, it's important to read the questions that we're asking for. I will be doing another application Thursday specifically on the personal statement coming up. I don't remember the date off the top of my head. As you scroll down, this will let you know where you can send your transcripts to. Again, I'll do another application Thursday specifically on transcripts, but this is the address that you can use. And then you're going to come to your checklist. Right now, we have a bunch of red X's because I haven't uploaded anything for this application. This is where you can see what you're missing for your application. And when you're ready to upload documents, down here towards the bottom, you will select this drop-down menu, and then you'll select the document type. So if you're ready to upload your resume, you'll scroll down, you'll find the resume, choose file, and you'll upload your resume. And then again, it might not be instant, but I would say within 10, maybe 15 minutes, the page will refresh and it'll show a green check mark to show that you have uploaded your resume. So what's going to happen here is you will continue until all of these things are green check boxes. Once we have a completed application is when an application is submitted, the application fee is paid, and everyone has a green check mark right here. I will review your application. I personally review every single application to the School of Nursing for the graduate programs, and we will then send off to faculty review, and we will let you know your next steps once our faculty have reviewed it. And that is how to fill out the application for the UB School of Nursing graduate programs. As I said earlier, these are meant to be short, little quick snapshots on how to do something specific to the application. So for those of you that are watching this in the future, if you do have any questions, please feel free to contact me at my email, which is listed on the screen, or my phone number. I'd be happy to walk you through everything. And at this point, I'm going to stop the recording, but have a great day, everyone.